What clear images! You can almost feel the breeze blowing through those trees. This is high vision, which is expected to be the television of the future. High vision is the name given to the high-definition television system developed by NHK. We'll show you what this new technology of high vision has made possible. With the advent of high vision, TV screens at home will be bigger like this, with clearer, more beautiful pictures. Scenes like this will look fresher and brighter seen through high vision's camera. We can clearly see these microorganisms called volvox. They're just 500 microns in diameter. High vision is especially advanced in its ability to discern details and in its resolution capability. What gives high vision better resolution capability? This is how TV pictures looked about 60 years ago, when they were projected for the first time in Japan. As you can see, the TV camera is filming a symbol on the right-hand side and projecting it on the cathode ray tube on the left-hand side. This early cathode ray tube used only 40 scanning lines to portray images. In Japan from 1953, the TV system used 525 scanning lines for monochrome and later for color. But with only 525, the information on a conventional TV screen is just 1/4 of that in high vision.
This may be hard to believe, but Peter and I saw the dress rehearsal.
High vision's cathode ray tube uses 1,125 scanning lines. Its screen is rectangular, a shape more suitable for the normal human field of vision. You can look long and closely at the fine-grained pictures with very little eye strain, and the optical viewing angle is tripled to 30 degrees. Various studies on improving TV pictures have been underway in other countries. Let's compare two other new systems, MEC and EDTV, with high vision. The high vision picture is on the left, while the MEC picture is on the right. MEC has been developed mainly in Europe. The basic difference is that MEC and EDTV are modifications of the existing system, while high vision is a completely new creation. Everything is innovative, from camera to receiving set. High vision's clear pictures can make all sorts of programs more fun. In one scene, the high-vision camera catches both a ball flying to the outfield and a runner reaching second base. In the case of performing arts, like Japan's kabuki drama, you can feel as if you're actually in a theater watching the stage. Even in a long shot like this, you can see each performer clearly. Sports programs, relays from theaters, and movies made with high vision can be watched in small video theaters like this. Making movies with high vision can create more beautiful pictures, but it's likely to cost less than conventional methods in the future. And the techniques for projection are simpler too. In addition, broadcasting satellites will send high vision pictures and sound to viewers at home. Let's see how high vision pictures are transmitted. If you enlarge a picture on a TV screen, you see it consists of basic units called picture elements. With twice as many scanning lines, high vision has more than four times as many picture elements as the conventional TV system. In the conventional system, picture elements are resolved and then transmitted through radio waves. But this can't be done in high vision because there's so much more information. To transmit high vision, NHK has developed a new system that allows scanning of picture elements by alternate sections and on alternate lines. Each picture is scanned four times. It's called MUSE, or Multiple Sub-Nyquist Sampling Encoding. As each picture is resolved into four parts, one-fourth of the total information is transmitted at one time. For its sound, high vision uses the PCM, or pulse code modifier system, the same as that used for compact discs. As you can see, the PCM system is not picking up any superfluous noise. The use of high vision is not limited to broadcasting. Its ability to reproduce color and texture, for example, makes it an ideal medium for what may be called catalogs in motion. You can use it to see how it looks in a particular outfit. Processing pictures this way is easy with high vision. High vision reproductions are like fine-grained photographs in a magazine. A system is being developed to use high vision in art museums. Combined with laser discs, high vision can create a database of artworks. Linked to this database through a broadcasting satellite or optical fiber cables, you could obtain a copy of the Mona Lisa or information about Leonardo da Vinci anywhere in the world. High vision offers countless possibilities for the future. It will open the way to a wealth of beautiful images.